Today we have a practice lesson number 7. The topic of lesson is heterogeneous equilibria. I will remind you that we are talking about system consisting of two phases. There is a solution of some electrolyte and there is some precipitate of salt. So here is the some solution. Let's write it the way that it will be the salt A, B, and this salt is electrolyte, so it is dissociated as A plus it is cation and B minus it is anion, and there is precipitate, we write A, B. And here we write small letter C means crystallic. There is equilibrium. So between these two phases, there is equilibrium. The salt is forming and dissolving at the same time. And to write that equilibrium, we will use the following approach. We write AB crystallic, two arrows because there is equilibrium, and here in solution there are cation and anion, and we always have to write saturated solution here, saturated solution. This is the right way of writing heterogeneous equilibrium. To make a conclusion about will be precipitate formed or not, we have to calculate concentration product. Concentration product is Cp, and we will compare it with solubility product, and we will compare if Cp is higher than Sp, or if it is lower, or if it is equal, and then we will make a conclusion. This I told you in the lecture, how to make the conclusion. But basically all problems in that topic are about calculating of Cp. So this is the first problem. Please stop the video and write it down, and I will show you how to solve it. So first you have to write the reaction. What happens if we mix silver nitrate and potassium chloride? I write the equation of ionic exchange. So there will be formed silver chloride and potassium nitrate. Potassium nitrate is a soluble substance, and potassium chloride and silver nitrate also soluble substance, but silver chloride is low soluble compound, so we write this small c here. Now let's write the heterogeneous equilibrium for silver chloride. Two arrows, here small c. And it is saturated solution. So basically you have to understand the following. We had two electrolytes, two soluble electrolytes. And these soluble electrolytes exist in solution in form of ions. I write dissociation for soluble electrolytes. And we have to calculate concentration product for poorly soluble salt. It is that salt. So the concentration product for silver fluoride is the concentration of silver multiply concentration of chloride. Where can we take this concentration? We can assume that since the salt is dissociated fully, the concentration of silver will be equal to concentration of silver nitrate. So before we mixed two solutions, we had some concentrations. It is given here and here. But after mixing of two solutions, the concentration were changed. How can we calculate the new solution, new concentration of silver nitrate? I will write here new. We can do step by step. We have to calculate the number of moles and divide it to the volume of total solution. So what is the total volume, new volume? I write here, it is 10 milliliters plus 5 milliliters, so 10 plus 5 is 15. So after mixing of two solutions, we got 15 milliliters. So how to calculate number of moles which we put into the system? We take the molar concentration, 0.99 mole per liter, and multiply to the volume, 10 milliliters. I will write 0.01 liter. I will use liter to show the volume, because in molar concentration here is below liter, so it's more correctly to write also in liters. And now I divide the total volume. The total volume also we have to write in liters. 0.015 liters. If you do that calculation, you will get 0.6 mole per liter. And the concentration of silver, of iron, it will be the same as the concentration of silver nitrate. So it will be the same. Nu, yes. So it is 0.6 moles per liter. Now we have to find the concentration of chloride. The concentration of chloride will be equal to new concentration of potassium chloride. We use the same approach. Number of moles divided by total volume, because the concentration was changed after the mixed two solutions. 0.3 mole per liter multiply 5 milliliters, 0.005 liters, this is liters, divided 0.015 liters, and it's equal to 0.1 mole per liter. And so the concentration of chloride also equal to 0.1 mole per liter. So the concentration product, it is the main question, it is equal to 0.6 multiply 0.1. So it will give us 6 power 10 minus 5. And there are no units for concentration products, because it will depend on the number of cations and anions in low soluble salt. In some cases, we will multiply not concentration, but concentrations in power of stoichiometric coefficients. So there are no stable units for concentration products. Problem number two. Will the precipitate formed if you mix 10 milliliters of 0.02 moles per liter silver nitrate solution with 5 milliliters of 0.1 moles per liter potassium chloride solution? And there is given SP solubility product. We will use the same approach as we did on previous problem. We will calculate concentration product. It will be equal the concentration of silver multiplied concentration of chloride. I will do it a little bit faster because on previous problem we did the similar calculation, but there was another numbers. So the concentration of silver, physical concentration of silver nitrate, nu. And so we take 0.02 multiply 0.01, this is moles per liter, this is liter, and divided by total volume 0.015 liter, and here is multiply sign, and the concentration is 0.013 moles per liter. Now we calculate the concentration of chloride. It will be equal concentration of potassium chloride nu. We take 0.1 moles per liter multiply 5 milliliters, it is 0.05 liters divided by 0.015 liters. It will be equal 0.033 moles per liter. Now we calculate the CP concentration product 0.013 moles per liter multiply 0.033 moles per liter, and it's equal 4.3 multiplied 10 power minus 4 I'm checking, yes, and we see that solubility product is 10 power minus 10 here. And if we compare these two numbers, we will see that concentration product is higher than solubility product. So we can make the conclusion that precipitate will be formed. I will write like that. Now let's do the next problem. Please stop the video and write down the problem. So first let's write the equation of forming of precipitate. Magnesium hydroxide is low soluble compound. So magnesium chloride is soluble. We add sodium hydroxide, and it will give us magnesium hydroxide. And to balance the reaction, we will put here 2 plus 2 sodium chloride. And this is low soluble compound. Now let's write heterogeneous equilibria. Crystal, it's low soluble. 2 arrows, it forms magnesium plus 2 hydroxide ions. We have to find the concentration of magnesium chloride, and basically we have to find the molar concentration of magnesium, which we need to form the precipitate. Precipitate is formed from 2 ions, magnesium and hydroxide ions. Precipitate is formed when concentration product is equal to solubility product. The concentration product for that salt will be written like that. The molar concentration of magnesium multiply the concentration of hydroxide ions power 2. These two we write because here we have two hydroxides. So the concentration of magnesium we can write using solubility product, which is given. Solubility product divided by concentration of hydroxide ions power 2. So let's put numbers here. 6.0 multiplied 10 power minus 10 divided by 0.1 power 2. And it will give us 6.0 10 power minus 12. And it is moles per liter. Or big M, it's the same unit. So basically the concentration of magnesium chloride will be the same as concentration of magnesium. It will be 6 multiplied 10 power minus 12 mole per liter. This is the answer. The last problem, please write it down. Calculate the solubility of barium carbonate in moles per liter and in grams per liter. And the solubility product for barium carbonate is given. Let me remind you from lecture material what is solubility. Solubility is the molar concentration in the saturating solution. It shows how many moles of substance are dissolved in 1 liter of water. It is measured in moles per liter. So what it means practically? If you have some low soluble compounds, but you have to prepare a transparent solution with no precipitate, you have to know how many grams or how many moles you have to take and put in the solution, in the solvent. And if you put more than solubility, you will get precipitate. If you put less, you will get transparent solution. So this is very practical characteristic of solution. And the solubility can be found from solubility product. And from solubility product, you will find it in moles per liter. But it is more practical to calculate in solubility in grams per liter. And to convert solubility in moles per liter to grams per liter, you have to multiply it on molar mass. Now I will show you how to calculate the solubility. Find solubility from solubility product. Let's write heterogeneous equilibrium for simple salt like A, B. So there is equilibrium, and in saturated solution we have cations and anions, and this is saturated solution, and this is precipitate. But I explained to you that we consider the situation when there is no precipitate. So basically, in that solution, the molar concentration of cation and anion equal to solubility measured in moles per liter. And these molar concentrations are equal. So we can say that solubility product will be equal solubility multiply solubility, because solubility product is a product of two equilibrium concentrations, and these two concentrations are equal to S. So solubility product is equal S power 2. Or we can convert that formula and write that for substances like A, B, the solubility is a square root from solubility product. So for more complicated low soluble compounds such as AN, BM, the solubility will be calculated using that formula. There will be root, but the degree of that root will be N plus M. And here, under the root, there will be solubility product, and here will be N power N multiply M power M. This is general formula, and dependent on the coefficients, if N and M are not one, if it differs, you will put these numbers to the formula, and the formula will be corrected. For example, N equal 1 and M equal 1. It is a B compound. The solubility will be 1 plus 1, solubility product 1 power 1, multiply 1 power 1. So it's square root from solubility product. This we already found. If we have compound like A2B, so N is equal to M is equal 1, the solubility will be equal root of 1 plus 2 degree solubility product 2 power 2 multiply 1 power 2, so it's cube root solubility product divided by 4. So now let's solve the problem. We have barium carbonate. There is one cation and one anion. So solubility will be calculated as square root from solubility product of barium carbonate, and it will be equal square root 8.1 multiplied 10 power 9, and it is equal 9 multiply 10 power minus 5, and it is in moles per liter. I will erase it. And now we have to find the solubility measured in grams per liter. So we will take that number 9 multiply 10 power minus 5 moles per liter, multiply by molar mass of barium carbonate. The molar concentration of barium carbonate is 197 grams per mole. So if we do multiplication, we'll get the answer 1.77 multiply 10 power minus 2 grams per liter. So if you want to prepare saturated solution of barium carbonate, we have to wait 17 milligrams, and dissolve it in 1 liter of water, and you will get saturated solution. If we will add more barium carbonate to that solution, there will be precipitate.